IVM.
Hey all, my name is Siddharth Deshmukh and I'm the traveling professor. And I teach various subjects like digital transformations, marketing, business of media, blah, 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 etc. This podcast is my diary of sorts. This is the traveling professor's diary where I share cheer, insights, anecdotes from my journey and experiences. This is what I have in store for you today. I'm in London sipping on wonderful famous grouse and just enjoying the absolute chill that December brings, you know, to the table, December, January brings to the table. And in this reminiscence, I'm just, you know, you can't really step outside. It's cold. So I'm kind of hooked on to YouTube, Netflix, what have you. I'm looking at Joe Rogan. And I'm looking at various other podcasts like Tim Ferriss's one and so many other famous ones, right? And I'm wondering what makes them tick, right? And we take podcasts for granted. Now, podcasts seem to have replaced radio for a lot of the early adopters and influencers. And people are saying that podcasts bring about a lot of flexibility and customization and a lot of interesting things that allow you to, you know, connect to your interest and your desire as far as listening to somebody's concerned. And while that is great, I actually think that there might be something slightly different that I wanted to explore with this podcast. I had the privilege of doing two podcasts at IVM, one with Filter Coffee, who is, you know, Karthik Nagarajan, and one with, Trupti, who is an actor, but who runs a podcast called Golgappa. And one of them was in Marathi and the other was in English. And I found both of them to be amazing interviewers. So when I was doing the podcast with both of them, I realized how much skill is required to become a fantastic podcast interviewer. It is quite an underrated thing. And you know why it is underrated? It's underrated because both of these interviewers were skilled in having an unstructured conversation. Now, what's an unstructured conversation? So there is no connect, or there's no crescendo, or there's no planning. Of course, there are a few set of questions that every, you know, interviewer on doing a great podcast will have. But these interviewers know how to play with the moment. They are moving here and there. They understand the pulse and the tempo, and they are ever present. And you know, that's the biggest strength that a podcast actually brings to the table. The fact that you're having a conversation which is not scripted, which is not out of the past, which is not, you know, totally, you know, bullshitty from, and you know, coming from a place of complete abstract imagination. It is focused on the present moment. The context is very sensitive. And what tends to happen is that it's a tightrope between actually having the flexibility to go into any kind of direction that the interviewee will go into, but yet following a certain script that allows for the audience to really know more about things. So that's what I learned. And then I started beginning to think about podcasts as a medium that allow the human mind to go into a certain states of being. Now, while that is true for almost all media, podcasts do it very differently from every other medium. Let me explain what I mean. If you look at when we listen to podcasts when we are about to fall asleep. Yeah, that's how I listen to a podcast. I listen to Joe Rogan, or I listen to Tim Ferriss, or I listen to, you know, Lex Friedman, who does a wonderful podcast on artificial intelligence. I listen to so many other podcasts like Sean Carroll's on quantum physics, and so on and so forth. But I listen to them only halfway, because halfway through, I've drifted off to sleep. Perhaps I use it in lieu of a meditation app or a go-to-sleep app or the rest of it. But the podcast continues to play as I fall asleep and I learn something beautifully, and the rest of it perhaps goes into my subconscious. Who knows? But that's the beauty of listening and drifting off to a beautiful podcast. Now, the second time when I listen to a podcast is when I've finished teaching at a place and I'm driving back to my home, especially when I'm in Pune, and I'm driving and I'm, you know, stuck in traffic, doing nothing, and I'm listening to this podcast and I'm converting what could be a very frustrating traffic jam, you know, to something which is less frustrating. I'm learning, but it's still going on. So I'm kind of happy. I feel two things. One is I'm happy because I'm transported, okay, into a different world, into a different context. So I'm relaxed. So my blood pressure isn't high. I'm listening to a wonderful, you know, thing. And somewhere I feel secretly, you know, one up on the world. It's like the world is delivering me this traffic jam, but I'm one up on the world because I'm listening to Joe Rogan's podcast with, say, Neil deGrasse Tyson, and I'm learning about astronomy, you know, when I'm stuck in Kothrud in a traffic jam. So that kind of helps me feel very good and fulfilled about myself. Like I'm doing something with this moment that makes me transcend it. And there are so many other places that we can listen to podcasts when we are doing household chores and the rest of it. And the whole premise seems to be that we are looking at podcasts as a means of connecting to the present moment, but to our subconscious as well, and convert that whole feeling of being tense or being anxious or being bored or being lazy or being tired into something which is more pleasing, naturally relaxing, and the rest of it. So to any podcaster who is doing something like this, I think, you know, that's a fantastic service that these guys are giving. I'm just starting this podcast of mine. I don't know whether, you know, it will reach a place where, you know, some of these other podcasts are. But I so enjoy being on the other side and just listening to them. And here's where I hope that listening to this podcast diary entry of mine has brought a little happiness to you and a little insight, perhaps, or maybe just a different way of looking at things, right? Thank you so much for listening to this one. If you want to listen to more podcasts of this type or different types even, go to ivmpodcast.com or look at the app. IBM podcast app. And if you want to follow me, hey, I'm always, as usual, the traveling professor on Instagram and LinkedIn. I'll see you soon.
I hope you enjoyed that show. We'd like to thank our sponsors for the week, Storytel and Intel. And let me tell you a couple of things that you should check out this week. On Golgappa, host Tripti is joined by Girija Godbole. She speaks about how acting and theater shaped her as a person. On the Empowering series, Zarina is in conversation with the host of Top Retail's Madhuri Advani. They talk about storytelling and ongoing issues in our country from CAA, NRC, and protests. On the Habit Coach, Ashton talks about the fear of failure and how it's fine to fail. The Simplified Gang is back with the last part to their 2019 recap. Join Chuck, Naren, and Tony as they talk about Amazon, Brexit, and Gully Boy. On Pulia Bazi, Pranay and Saurabh discuss the future of electric vehicles in India with Rahul Raj, co-founder of Inverted, an energy storage company. Thanks and keep listening.
How many times have you motivated yourself to improve your sleep or lose weight or be more productive? How many times have you failed? Hi, my name is Ashton Doctor. Tune into my show, The Habit Coach Podcast, where we focus on creating small, tiny habits to improve your life instead of those big, impossible tasks. So make listening to me a habit every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday on the IVM Podcast app or ivmpodcast.com. or on your favorite podcasting app.